Why trade tops the agenda as it meets Obama? Could the biggest free trade area in the world be announced this week? Well, that's the ambition that sits at the top of the agenda as Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe undertakes a week-long trip to Washington, though the final announcement is unlikely to be this week. Abe's visit is being termed historic as he is the first Japanese PM to be invited to address both houses of Congress on Wednesday, and any remarks that he makes on the 70th anniversary of World War II will be closely monitored. If or Abe and perhaps also U.S. President Barack Obama, it's their progress on a trade deal that is at the top of the agenda. Abe has said that they are near agreement on the Trans-Pacific Partnership TPP, which would create the largest free trade area in the world, linking the countries in Asia-Pacific ranging from Central America to Southeast Asia. I've written before about the ambitious TPP, which notably excludes China, a notable exception at that. Given all of Japan's economic challenges, struggle to defeat deflation as price increases have fallen back to zero, and low productivity to name a few, would a trade pact really make a huge difference? Estimates by economists put the gains at 0.66% of GDP that increases to 2% by 2020 if factors like foreign direct investment are included. For an economy that is struggling to grow, these are not huge amounts but certainly not negligible. Line: what is the Trans-Pacific Partnership? Proposed free trade deal between 12 Pacific Rim countries, the U.S., Japan, Brunei, Malaysia, Vietnam, Singapore, Australia, New Zealand, Canada, Mexico, Chile and Peru, estimated to cover anywhere between 1/3 to 40% of world trade but is missing a key Pacific economy, China, seen as a way of counterbalancing China's economic influence in the region, but U.S. officials say the country is welcome to join the agreement in the future negotiation.